Now, let us come to the point. The plain fact is this, that they are the terrorists. They are forcing and coercing the people into submission, making them to take the guns against their wishes, and sometimes using the money power that they have acquired by collecting money from the transporters, from the mine owners, from the rich people and poor people everywhere, and the Kendu leaves, and they are using this big money in which their big leaders are living with great lavishness, as has come out with a lot of interrogations, and these poor tribals are being made an excuse. You know, they go to tribal areas, they say it's a tribal cost. They go to Bihar, they say it is a caste cause. They go to the Uttarakhand area, they say it is of the hill people who have been neglected. They go to the Muslims and they say it is an Islamic cause. They try to find out anyone who has got any point of alienation to rope them in against the state. War is against the state. War is against India. They would like to establish the rule of the gun, and the polity that they want to have is a type of a political system
yes, Saroj,
which is brought through weapon and
Sarojgiri's response. Yes, 5 minutes on this debate. Process, hear from Sarojgiri, please. The counter. Yes, Ajit Doval. Hear from Sarojgiri. Then I'm coming to Maruf and Atul Ajay.
My response. My response is that I think what Mr. Doval is saying is very interesting, and I would like all of us to concentrate on that for a minute. He said that Maoist goes in different areas from Uttarakhand to Punjab and Assam and everywhere and tries to mobilize the alienation of the people, right? And next thing he says is that they are doing it in order to overthrow the Indian state. Now, my question to the House today, and including Professor Mr. Doval, is that what is the problem in actually addressing people's alienation?
Yeah, so if people
are alienated, people are oppressed, people are exploited, yeah, you know, then okay. Maoist,
I think that's a very interesting question. I would like to
actually mobilize that. Well, and I think that is a, the
exactly.
You see, Saroj,
let me give an answer.
Let Ajit respond to that.
Now, let me give an answer.
No, one second. First of all, Mr. Doval. Mr. Doval.
Alienating these people.
Mr. Doval.
Before you come in,
I'd also like to add here. We can't have an ostrich mentality where we believe that there is no alienation. Of course there is
not
alienation.
At all. One second. Alienated.
One, please.
Then Maoists are addressing that alienation.
Dr. Sarojgiri.
And at some point, the Dr. Indian Sarojgiri, state
Dr. Sarojgiri,
is not able to tolerate that. Hold on.
Yeah, but Dr. Sarojgiri, the only difference.
The Indian state is not able to tolerate the fact that people Dr. are Giri, oppressed and alienated are being mobilized by the Maoists.
Please understand one
and
thing.
The only
Dr. Sarojgiri. Dr. Giri, please. Dr. Giri, one second.
So, Arnab, what happened?
Dr. Giri, are you going to listen to me, get the response? You made a point. Let me get a response from someone else. Dr. Giri, 1 minute.
Deny that it is a massacre.
Yeah, okay. So you made
a terror attack. I'm not going to deny that. But the question is, I have every terrorist. If the Maoists are giving a voice to that,
Dr. Giri, let's not have a. I can't compete with Dr. Giri. Let us never have any perverse logic which says that, first of all, let us believe there is alienation. Of course there is alienation. But to use that alienation directly or indirectly have a perverse argument which directly or indirectly justifies such violence and terror is also ridiculous. Ajit Doval, and then I'm going to close with Maruf.
I'd like to add something.
Yeah.
A very small rejoinder. What I want to say is this. In a free society, there are always groups who have got some demand which are unfulfilled. You create an alienation by telling them that you are being deliberately discriminated upon and the only solution is through the gun.
Exactly.
If you join us, take the gun, you will be able to throw the paper tiger, and in a free political society, it becomes all the more easy because the democratic freedoms are used against the state. Now, this is exactly the window which the Naxalites have been using. They have been using in different areas. Where are the tribal, this thing, it's only in the tribal areas that they are talking about that they are the messiah of tribals. How many of the leaders in the Politburo are the tribals?
Maruf, in
Bihar area, they started using the Paswans against the, against the Ranveer
Sena. Mr. Doval, sir.
And then they started taking the lower class,
Mr.
and now
Doval.
There's a conflict between Yadav and the Paswans. Now, let me tell you one thing. That is, there will be. Everyone has got one grievance or the other. You try to capitalize and exploit that grievance for achieving your political objective and instigating the people to take their weapons, make them available through the money that you illegally procure from within and the help that you get from outside.
Maruf.
I'd like to come in here with just three quick points. One is, these problems are politico-military problems. They don't have political solutions. They don't have military solutions per se. But a combined approach to it at a national level is going to get us moving forward. The tragedy is, in the last 8-9 years, the current Prime Minister has referred to this as India's gravest threat 3 or 4 times, it is at least on record. But beyond that, nothing has happened. You know, center-state relations are so strained in some of these areas that there's no movement forward. The second aspect is, you need to contain the problem. You need to contain with a far more professional military approach without, let me tell, those who are supportive of the ideologies of those who are fighting the state of India, that you don't need to all the time fire bullets to contain a problem. Yeah. You can contain a problem. You have to think through a solution of what good governance measures you will provide, whether it's schools, roads, electricity, medical, etc., etc.
Yeah.
And while you do that, you start talking to them and try and ask them that would they like to operate within the Constitution of India or not. If that is a parameter they are willing to accept, we can still talk to them. But at the short of everything that has emerged in the last weekend, that this is a ghastly act and it must meet a strong rejoinder. Otherwise, the message that goes down is that the Indian state can't defend itself, and at least those who are leading political figures will continue to be the victims of such acts, whether you call it ideological, whether you call it barbaric, or whether you can act just to convey that their alienation is not being addressed.
You see, Maruf, I just have one last question to Madhu Sareen, who's been wanting to come in. I know you want to make your own point. I want to simply ask you one basic question. You would remember this incident which happened deep in the Karmatia jungles. There was an attack between the Maoists, you know, there was a, and the CRPF. It was Latehar, I think, in Jharkhand. You remember that, right? So, Madhu Sareen, you know what had happened then was that a CRPF jawan died. These Maoists, they cut open the body of the CRPF jawan. They cut it up. Then they put a 1.5 kilo unexploded bomb inside his abdomen. They cut his stomach. Then they put the bomb inside his abdomen and then stitched the abdomen back. He was a 29-year-old constable. I think, I'm not sure, Babulal something. So, when the jawan's body was found, as soon as the body was picked up, the mine exploded, and I don't even want to describe what happened to the body. I want to ask you today, which alienation, however grave the deprivation, and I'm sure there is, justifies what happened? And I have just 4 more words, ma'am. You allow me, please. What are these rules of combat? If this is not terrorism, please give me another word for it.
The way I see it, that particular incident was, you know, the work of a sick mind, which I would equate with those adults who are raping 2-year-olds. Right. They are equally sick.
Man,
and what's the point in discussing individual incidents?
Don't,
I think
don't
it's terrible.
Justify.
I think what is important...
Anyway.
No, let me just get back to... I think the key issue which needs... How do we move forward? What has happened... This last incident of the attack on the Congress party leaders is dreadful. I don't think anyone here agrees that, you know, that is acceptable. But so are so many other things which are not acceptable. And if we are to move forward, how do we move forward?
Well, just
we
because...
need to, you know, create conditions for justice.
This country...
In these areas... Mr. Dhawal, someone just talked about, you know, need to stick to the Constitution of India. Let me point out that the Constitution of India provides special protection to tribal areas from where, you know, a lot of the laws can be withheld.
Well, I asked a very specific question. I asked you a question. I asked you what word you would use to define what happened.
Provided the tribals don't resort to terrorism, ma'am. Provided the tribals don't resort to such dastardly acts of terrorism.
I think you see what happens is the cycle of violence is to stop somewhere. And while I don't believe everyone knows there's alienation, no alienation can justify terrorism. No alienation. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen, for joining me on the NewsHour debate tonight. Thank you.